Working. This is what's going to help him now. What's going to help him now? His a'mal going to help him now. Now he's buried inside the qabr. People are burying him. People are putting soil. People are leaving him. Now Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa qala al-Nabiyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yatba'u al-mayyita thalatha fayarju'u ithnani wa yabqa wahidun yarju'u ahluhu wa maluhu wa yabqa amaluhu. The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and remember this my friend, if you love your money, if you love this world, if you love the houses of this world and the cars of this world, nothing will help you inside the qabr. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam already said, يَتْبَعُ الْمَيِّتَ ثَلَاثٌ. When a person dies, three things follows him. How many things?
Three
things. Now, if you understand three things, inshallah, our eyes will open, we will understand. Three things. Three things will go with the person. What are the three things? Your maal, your money, your wealth, your family. Does your family go with you in the qabr? They go with you, they go and bury you inside the qabr. Three things go with him, listen. And your a'mal. Rasulullah then said, فَيَرَجِمُوا إِثْنَانِ. Two things come back. They don't go inside the qabr with that person. Tell her, I love my wife so much, I might as well lie with her inside the qabr and bury us both. Tell her, I love my dad so much, let me go inside with him. It doesn't matter how much you love your wife, how much you love your father, no one is willing to sacrifice their life and go inside the qabr with someone else. فَيَرْجِعُ إِثْنَانِ. Two things remain. They come back. What are the two things? مَعْلُهُ وَأَهْلُهُ. Your mal, return, come back. And your family. Your daughter, your son, your brother, your uncle, they all come back and they leave you inside. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَيَبْقَى عَمَلُ. Your amal stays inside with you. Your amal, your reward, your thawab, your amal stays inside the qabr with you. So what we understand from this, only amal can help us. Only amal and a'mal can help us inside the qabr. Nothing else. So what we learn from this, that when we are here in this world, we should do amal, we should do a'mal, we should pray and we should ask Allah, we should do ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when I die, when I'm buried inside the qabr, a'mal, my amal, my namaz, my zakat, my hajj, my tilawat, Quran, my tasbihat, helps me inside the qabr. But if I don't pray namaz, then who's going to help me? If I don't recite Quran, then who's going to help me? If I don't do tasbihat, who's going to help me? I am so busy making money, I am so busy making money, that I don't have time to pray five times salah. I am so busy making money, I don't have time to do tasbihat. I am so busy making money, I don't have time to recite the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am so busy looking after my family, I am so busy making business, I am so busy making houses in Pakistan, Bangladesh and India, I am so busy making houses here, I forgot about my death, I forgot about qabr, I forgot about that I have to stand before Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This life is nothing. When you are gone, when death comes to you and people bury you inside, even your own sons and daughters don't remember you. After a couple of weeks, couple of months, they are so, mashallah, they're enjoying their own life. Once a year or Eid time, or small Eid or Bakra Eid, they remember you, they'll go and visit you. That's it. The time you gave for them, the time you worked for them, the money you got for them, the money you earned for them. Hours and hours you working in the office, in the call center. Hours and hours, 10 hours a shift you worked, so your children can get better life. You worked hours and hours so they can enjoy their life. And by doing this, you disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By doing this, you read 3-time namaz, 4-time namaz, 2-time namaz, but namaz as far as 5 times daily. You are gone, you left the wealth, you left money, your children are enjoying them. Your children are you know, they're spending their money, they're spending their time, they're enjoying that money. For you, what happened? Nothing. You just wasted your time and your zindagi and your life. The chance, the one chance you had, you've wasted it. The one chance we've had, we've wasted it. Sometimes what happens, when a father is wealthy, he works so much, he's got so much money, and he leaves money and wealth for the children, that wealth and money can turn them evil as well. The money and wealth can them turn them evil as well. You left so much money that they are enjoying so much, they're spending so much, they're spending money in haram, they're spending money outside, gambling, they're spending money in drinking alcohol and other stuff, because with your own money. So who's going to get the guna for it? Your money. You can't say nana. Your money is your money. You left behind, so you wanted better life, but you didn't give him the Islamic life, you gave him the non-Islamic life. And then what happened? They're enjoying it. And you are in the qabr. Allah knows best what he will do. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, give us a tawfiq to, you know, understand this life and the hereafter also. So I was mentioning when a person, Allah Rasul said, فَيَرَدُهُ إِثْنَانِ, two things remain, your man and your family. وَيَبْقَى عَمَلُ, your amal will remain inside. Now the family members bury you inside, they'll leave. You can hear their footsteps, they are leaving your qabr. They are going away. They are going away. You are inside the qabr, your soul comes back into your body. And they mention in the hadith that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, a person is lying inside the qabr, Munkar and Nakir, the two angels, they come to the qabr, inside the qabr, and they will wake him up, they will call him, he will wake up, he will get up. And they will ask him, how many questions? How many?
Three.
Jazakumullah. Three questions. They will ask three questions. Before qabr, there were three things going with you. Two things remain. That was your amal, mal, and your family. And one thing remain inside your amal. When you go inside the qabr, after you leave your family, and your father, your mother, your child, whoever you buried, you leave them. That angel comes. Munkar and Nakir. They come and ask three questions. I'm telling you now, everyone knows the answer. Everyone knows the answer of the sual. Everyone knows the answer of the question. But knowing the answer of the question is not going to help you. What's going to help you? If you did amal on those three questions, then that will help you. So amal, that's what Allah says, أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. The amal is very important. Deeds are very important. So the Munkar and Nakir come. He says, Mar Rabbuk. Who is your Rabb? Who is your Lord? Everyone knows. Even a little child will say, my Lord is Allah. My Rabb is Allah. Allah, right? My Rabb is Allah. Can we answer this if we didn't follow the ahkam of Allah? We can't. If we disobeyed Allah and we didn't listen to Allah, then we will not be able to answer. The Muslim, mu'min, he will say, my Allah, Rabbi Allah. My Rabbuk, he will say, Rabbi Allah. Who is your Rabb? My Rabb is Allah. Because he prayed for Allah. He listens to Allah. He followed the orders of Allah. He followed the ahkam of Allah. He said, Rabbi Allah. He said, Rabbi Allah. The second question, what's your religion? Now the religion is Islam, our religion called Islam, Deen Islam. Now if mu'min, the mu'min will able to answer, he will say, my religion is Islam. But those who didn't follow Islam, when Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu dukhulu fi silmi kafa, enter Islam completely. What does that mean? That when you say, well, Allah, I submit myself to you, and when you submit yourself to Allah, then whatever Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, we have to follow it from A to Z. We have to follow. If Allah, the Islam, the Sharia, the Islam told us Don't take interest, we can't take interest. If Islam told us don't drink alcohol, we can't drink alcohol. If Islam told us that don't steal from people, you can't steal. If Islam told us respect your parents, you have to respect your parents. If Islam told us respect your elders, we have to respect our elders. If Islam told us that don't backbite, we can't backbite. If Islam told us not to lie, we can't lie. This is called Islam. Udkhulu fi silmi kafa. Submission. You submit yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If mu'min can answer, if a disobedient banda of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will say, I don't know. In the hadith is mentioned that when this question will be asked to a disbeliever or disobedient servant of Allah, the Mar Rabbuk, who is your Rabb, who is your Lord, he will say, the person inside the qabr will say, La adri. I don't know. I have no ilm, I have no knowledge, I don't know. Regarding Islam, what's your religion? I don't know. Because I never followed Islam. I followed the people outside. I followed the models of this world. I followed the society. I followed the big people. I followed the people who are business, who can talk, who is big, who are power. I don't know. The third question, what is the third question? Man nabiyuk, or who is this person? Many narration, many things, many